Why do we have to forgive them? Because when we forgive them, my beloved sisters, then Allah will forgive you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us. لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى قال وليعفو وليصفحوا ألا تحبون أن يغفر الله لكم والله غفور رحيم. In Surah An-Nur, when Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه said about Masdah bin Affan, when he said, and Masdah was a man who, a poor man, whom Abu Bakr used to financially support him. But Masdah bin Affan رضي الله عنه made a mistake by circulating the rumors that have been mentioned about Aisha, Ummana Aisha. And he started repeating and saying she committed zina. I'm sorry, she committed zina. And she did this, and she did that. And then Abu Bakr said, Wallahi, I will stop helping financially this man. Look what he did. He talked about the honor of his daughter. And Allah revealed this ayah. And he said, وَلِيَعْفُوا يَا مُحَمَّدْ Tell Abu Bakr, tell the mu'mineen, وَلِيَعْفُوا let them pardon and forgive. And then he said, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ Do you not love that Allah should forgive you? Don't you love that Allah, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ And Allah is unforgiving, most merciful. So when you forgive, when you forgive them, then Allah will forgive you. The second reason that you should forgive them is for the reward. Because when you do, and when you forgive them, number one, you're defeating the shaitan. You're defeating that shaitan that tried to cause fitna between you and your Muslim brother or sister. And at the same time, you're gaining the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And listen to what Allah said. قَالَ فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحْ Whoever forgives his brother or sister, وَأَصْلَحْ And he reconciles the relationship. He forgives. And he makes a reconciliation. يَقُلْ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ Allahu Akbar. His or her reward is due from Allah. His or her reward is due from Allah. Allahu Akbar. Inna Allah la yuhibbu al-zalimeen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, indeed Allah likes not the wrongdoers. Allah doesn't like the wrongdoers. So akhawati fillah, listen what Allah said. His reward, her reward is due from Allah. What does it mean? Look, it's not like your husband will reward you, or your father will reward you, or your brother will reward you, or your ambassador, or your governor, or the president, or the king. La wallahi. Allah is the king of all kings, the ruler of all rulers. He's the one who will reward you. Imagine. If nowadays someone says to you, Bill Gates is giving you a donation or is rewarding you for how the help that you helped him. Imagine how happy you will get. And imagine what would you expect a man that is a billionaire. If he gives, he will give $100,000, $1 million, maybe $5 million. Why? Because he's a millionaire. Imagine the reward that comes from Allah, the owner of the universe. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ His reward is due from Allah. From Allah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Wallahi Allahu Akbar. This is a reward, a great reward. Also, أَخَوَاتِ فِي اللَّهِ By pardoning and forgiving, this is you paving your way to Jannah. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ Because Allah says, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ Allah says, the good deed and the evil deed cannot be equal. Repel, O Abd Amat Allah. Respond, O Amat Allah. with one which is better. Respond. Allah is ordering the believers, the faithful believers. Allah is ordering the mu'mineen to be patient at the time of anger and to excuse those who treated them badly. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم. And Allah is saying then, verily, he between whom and you there is enmity. يعني between you and that individual is enmity. And there is a problem between you two. Treat him as a close friend. كأنه ولي حميم. A person that is your close friend, your close, your best friend, treat him like this. And then he said, قال وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم. He said, but none is granted, no one is granted the above behavior, no one is granted the quality that we just mentioned, except those who are patient. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا. None is granted, he said, again, except the honor, the owner of great portion. إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. Except with a person of great portion. And here, حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ, this great portion, it means Jannah, paradise. When someone comes to you with bad attitude, rebel that with positive and good conduct. When a person comes to you with transgression, respond with forgiveness. When a person comes to you and is angry, have sabr. When the person makes mistakes, then forgive that and be patient with them. بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنْ مُجَاهِدْ وَعَطَىٰ. They said, the best that you can means give them the salam. Welcome them warmly. How are you, sister? I haven't seen you for a while. MashaAllah. We missed you at the halaqa. At the masjid. Wallahi yuhub, inshaAllah. From Ahl al-Jannah bi idhnillah. Praise her. Show her her good points, MashaAllah. Treat her as though she is one of the best friends that you ever had. Though she was the one who was backbiting you yesterday. Though she was the one who saying all evil things about you. Though she embarrassed you in front of your friends. Though she cursed you. Though she lied about you. At the same time, this is how you should greet them. Some of the ulama, they said, no, you go and you shake their hands, and you hug them, and you treat them as though they are the best that ever exist. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةً. If there's an enmity between you, that individual, treat him as though كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ, as though he was a close, close, close friend. Now, أَخَوَاتِ فِي اللَّهِ. The other reason that we should forgive these people is for Allah. For the sake of Allah. Why? لِأَنَّ الْعَفُ. The word عَفُ, which is to pardon and to forgive, is one of the attributes of Allah. And forgiveness, Al-Ghafran, or Al-Ghafur, is one of the names of Allah. So when you yourself have that etiquette, that manners, and you forgive and you pardon, then you're exercising, you're practicing, and you're also taking part of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is something that is so beautiful. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَفُوًا غَفُورًا. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He Himself, He forgives and He pardons people. So this is أَخَوَاتِ فِي اللَّهِ. What from the Qur'an, but from the Sunnah also you have to learn. I'm sorry, from the other reason is for you to follow the Messenger of Allah, follow His footsteps, and let Him be our role models. And remember how many people He forgave and what He did, the people who treated Him badly, and how He treated them with kindness, how He, alhamdulillah, never ever mentioned, oh, how could I deal with you ever again when you said such and such about me?